Hello students, how are you? Hope you are fine. So today I'm going to show you a very interesting experiment regarding Archimedes principle. I have a request from one of my students to show me the Archimedes principle with activities so that you can understand. I have come up with an activity to show you and to make you understand what is Archimedes principle and how it works. So first of all, let me ask you a question. Suppose if you take an object like this, if you take an object, when you hold it here, you will feel a weight, isn't it? Now, if you put it inside the water, at that time if you hold it, then you will find the weight is little less. If you are going to a swimming class, you ask your trainer who is training you that swimming class, that when you hold them, or when he or she holds you inside the water, then he feel the same weight or little less. So you will definitely find it will be little less in when you are holding any object or anything, any body inside the water, it's little lighter. Why it is lighter? What is the reason behind it? Yes, that is because of Archimedes principle. And because of this principle only, small coin made up of iron sink inside the water, but a massive ship made up of iron floats on water. So if you look into the book, you will find that Archimedes principle says that when a body is immersed fully or partially inside a fluid, then it experiences a upward force which is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by that body. When you first time read this, you will find it's a cryptic message by Archimedes. But don't worry, I'm going to make it simple. So first of all, I will use not the partially immersed object or body, I will use the fully immersed body. So I will cut out the partially. Then if I come to the fluid means collectively known as liquid as well as gas. Fluid means which can flow. So liquid also can flow, gas also can flow. Instead of, we will not use the gas, that's why we will use the liquid. So that's why we will use the word liquid instead of fluid. The main liquid we are using, that is water. So I will use water. So now, what is the sentence form? Whenever a body fully immersed in water, it experiences an upward force which is equal to the weight of the water displaced by that body. Now it has become a little bit clear. Now in this situation, you will get two parts of this total sentence. First part is an object immersed fully inside the water, it experiences an upward force. This is the first part. And the second part is the upward force is equal to the weight of the displaced liquid by the body. So now coming to the first part of the sentence, you can see I have a beaker with a little amount of water and a object. Now if I put this object inside this liquid, when you do it at your home, when it fully immersed in liquid, you will experience a upward force. How? If you leave it, then it will pop out of the water. That means what? This object experiences an upward force by the liquid. And that upward force is known as upthrust or buoyancy or buoyant force exerted by the liquid in upward direction. So how you will measure the upward force of water? The upward force is the difference between the weight of any object in air and the weight of that object in water. So let's find it out. I have an object here, you can see. Now I will measure the weight of this object in air, and then after that I will measure the weight of this object inside this liquid in water, and we will find the difference in the weight, and that difference is the upward force of the. So for that I need a spring balance. Now check how much it is.
70 gram. You can see precisely, we can say 70 gram force, but for your convenience we will use 70 gram. Gram unit we will use for weight.
So this is 70 gram. Now if I put it inside this water, we will find there will be a loss in weight. This is almost 40 gram. When it is in air, that is the real weight of this object, and when it is in water, that is the apparent weight of this object. So what is the loss in weight? Loss in weight means loss in weight is equals to real weight minus apparent weight. So real weight is 70 gram and apparent weight is 40 gram. So what is the loss in weight? The loss in weight is 30 gram. So 30 gram is the loss in weight, and we know that upward force is the loss in weight, and that upward force is same as loss in weight, that is 30 gram. So upward force is how much? That is 30 gram, or precisely we can say 30 gram force. So this is the upward force. Now coming to the second part of the Archimedes principle, that is upward force is the weight of the water displaced by that body. So upward force I have got 30 gram force. Now I will see how much water is displaced. For that we need another beaker, and we need to measure the weight of this beaker. It's almost 40 gram. So weight of this beaker is 40 gram. Now I will put this object inside, and I will displace the liquid, and that liquid will be transferred here. How we'll do it? Just see. You can do these things at your home. I am just showing it to you. No need to have any Eureka can or something like that. Now I will pour this inside, fully immersed inside. So this much of water is displaced. So what is the weight of this water? How will find it out? Same measurement. First the weight of the beaker was 40 gram. Now weight of the beaker with water, how much it is? 70 gram force. The weight of this beaker with water, the water that is displaced here, okay, it's almost 70 gram force. So So weight of the beaker was 40 gram force, empty beaker, 40 gram force, and the weight of the beaker with water is 70 gram force. So weight of this water is 30 gram force. So this is the displaced liquid, displaced water, and the weight of this displaced water is 30 gram or gram force. So the upward force is 30 gram force, precisely we can say 30 gram force, and weight of the displaced liquid is also 30 gram force. So this is, both are equal, that means Archimedes is correct. So upward force is equals to the weight of the water displaced by this object. Let's come to the statement. Statement is there. What is that statement? Statement is, for if a body is fully or partially immersed. If I do it for partially immersed body, the object is partially immersed now. Loss in weight of this object is equal to the weight of this water displaced by this object when it is partially immersed. So Archimedes is true for in all situations. So what was our statement? That an object, when it is immersed fully or partially inside any fluid, then it experiences an upward force, and that upward force is equals to the weight of the displaced liquid by this object. So it works both for fully and partially immersed body, and it works for not only in water, it works for any fluid. Now coming to the summary of this total experiment, that upward force is equals to the weight of the liquid displaced. Very simple, so you can remember it like this. Upward force is what? Weight of the liquid displaced. Upward, WLD, weight of the liquid displaced. So loss in weight, what? Real weight minus apparent weight. Upward force is what? Weight of liquid displaced. And loss in weight is equals to upward force. Now if you ask that why the big ship don't sink inside the water, why it is floating, what is the reason behind it? The reason behind it, that suppose this is an object, the weight of this object is 70 gram and the upward force is 30 gram, means the volume of this object goes inside this water, same volume of water will displaced by this object. What is the volume of this object? 30 ml. So 30 ml of water displaced, and the weight of that water is the upward force. Now if I tell you that I have an object, this one, and what is the weight of this object? 10 gram is the weight of this object. Now if I put it inside, let's see how much water it is displaced. Displacing almost 25 ml of water, means volume of water is displaced. What is the weight of this water? The weight of this water will be 25 gram. Yes, it is 65, means 40 was the empty beaker and with water is 65, that means total the weight of this liquid is 25 gram. So 25 gram of water is displaced. Weight of this water displaced is equals to the up thrust or upward force. The upward force is how much? 25 gram. And what is the weight of this object? This object is 10 gram, we can say. So this object goes, this weight of this object is 10 gram in downward direction, and the upward force is 25 gram force. So it, instead of going downward, it will move up and float on water. So same as the case of ship, big ship, it is made up of iron, but inside the ship it's a hollow chamber, and inside that hollow chamber air is present, and air is very much lighter. So when the ship goes inside the water, it displaces a larger volume of water. Weight of that larger volume of water is more than the weight of that ship. Like here, the weight of this water displaced by this object is more than the weight of this object. So that's why it floats on water. So that's why when ships enter into the water, the volume of water displaced by that ship, the weight of that water is more than the weight of the ship. That's why ship floats on water. Have you got the point? So try this activity at your home and you will definitely, your ideas will be clear, your confusion will be clear, and you will have fun and you will understand better while doing this activity. Okay, so thank you all of you and have a good day.